Hello everybody and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today's a very special evening because I only just got this shipment of items. I just got my April Fairyloot box and I'm so excited to share it with you. So here's the box itself. It got a little bit like rattled on the way here, but that's okay. These boxes go through a lot, but that's okay because we are going to start and we are going to unbox this. I already like cut the like label that kind of tape this together just to like not accidentally like flash my address anywhere. So let's open this. Can't see anything, right? Okay, great. Okay, so as per usual, ooh, that's pretty. As per usual, we have this beautiful box that I'm in love with. I meant to do that. But we have this beautiful box with a bunch of goodies and trinkets in it, and I'm already really excited to see. And what fell out earlier is the spoiler card. And look at how gorgeous that is. Hold on, there we go. The glare of the light is in the way, but at least you get to see the whole of it. But like, this is so beautiful. I'm so intrigued. All right, so now that I've somewhat balanced this box on my knee here, we can start getting rid of the grass. It's very cute grass, but it can't stay forever. It can't. Ooh, what's this? Okay, so right on top, there's still more grass underneath, but it kind of looks like this from the angle. Oh, something's gonna fall. So be warned. So this is what it looks like from the top, bird's eye view. And we have this item first. I think these might be the cards that didn't fit or like somehow got like lost or like misplaced from the last batch, because I did get an email from Fairyloot saying that trading cards would be in this box and not the next one because something got like misplaced. But anyway, this is what it looks like, and it says heart fairy lights. Wait, are these actually fairy lights? Hold on. Produced from fairy. Oh my goodness, this is so cool. Okay, so this packaging is adorable, first of all. What the heck? I kind of like don't want to open it because it's so pretty. Like, look at this intricate design everywhere. It's so beautiful. Oh my goodness. Okay, so let's open these lights. Hold on, I'll let you wait. I have to see it. It's stuck. Hold on. I'm struggling. Give me a moment. I don't want to break them. Oh my gosh. Ah, there we go. Oh no. It's stuck. Hold on. Oh, there we go. We got it. All right, so. Oh my God, that's so cute. Okay, so this is what it looks like when you open it. It's so cute. Oh my gosh. And we need AA batteries in it. Okay. You can see like the little battery packaging. I love it. It's so pretty. Look at it. Look at it. I don't know if you can see that, but it's so pretty. Oh my gosh. Wow. Aw. They're adorable. Wait, so is this like a string of lights? This is very confusing. Okay, that was a little challenging, but we got it. Oh, just kidding. Nope, just kidding about that. Wait. Oh, I see. I swear I'm not an idiot, you guys. Okay. Oh my goodness. There we go. It's fine. It's fine. All right. This is what they look like. They're like a string of hearts. Heart fairy light. Yes. They're so cute. They're like kind of in the shape of a heart, but it's cute. This is what like they all look like. And I will get some AA batteries. So I'll be right back. All right. Batteries have been acquired. Okay. Let's move this little clanking box. Here we go. So just so you kind of get a better view. Awkward, but that's okay. So I don't know how well you can see them, but they have a golden hue, like a warm color to them. There you go. That's what they all look like. And you already know that I'm gonna be using these in all of my next bookish photos for my Instagram. I love these. All right, this is our next order of business, and it is Strange the Dreamer moth. Packaging looks like. I love that they always kind of keep the same kind of style for all of their packaging, even if it's like new. Let's take a look. I have like a jar that I just collect these pins in now. Oh my God, that's so beautiful, but it's upside down. It's so beautiful. this reminds me of the stingray creature that Moana's grandmother turns into after she passes away, and it's so beautiful. Like, look at how the colors just like radiate, and it's so beautiful. We have like teal, black, purple, gold, and I think here in this darker part is a navy blue. There are two little pin holders. I don't know what these are actually called. Two little pin holders on the back. I can't wait to add this to my pin collection. I'm so excited. I don't normally collect pins, but because Fairyloot starts to include them in their boxes, I'm like, why not? I'll start with whatever pins that they send me. I'm really excited. I love it. It's so cute. We found the deck of cards. It says Threads of Fate from fairyloot.com. So this is what the front looks like. Oh, the glare. That's okay. Look at it. It's so pretty. And I love these like pieces of thread because it works with the theme. It's amazing. And then the back looks like this. It's so intricately done. I love it. It was a little bit of a struggle, but that's okay. We got there. So this is what it looks like without the packaging. Oh no. Oh wait, it's supposed to open like that. I thought I broke it for a second. I was like, oh my God. But like the cards are like metallic. Like not actually metallic, but are they? No, it's just like painted. It's so pretty. Okay, I don't wanna mix up the cards. Okay, so this is what the ace look like. Look like? Looks like. But I will provide a more, oh, these are all so pretty. Here, I'll just like show you like this. Wait, what's the queen? Oh, that's so pretty. This probably has to be the character. These have to be characters from the book. Look at that, that's so pretty. Like, look at this. They're so beautiful. I love it. I'm gonna post like in detail pictures about this. But they're so beautiful. And then, oh wait, the Jack, those two. Okay, that's so cool. I love it. These are, I'm pretty sure these are all have to be characters from the book that it's supposed to be from. Oh my goodness. And the paint is like shiny and metallic red or metallic black. And it's like the numbers, these are what they look, oh, they kind of look like roses, but oh my goodness. And then this is what the Jack, Queen, and King look like. I'm losing my marbles. These are the diamonds. They're so well done. Like, look at this. I know you probably can't see that, but I will post more in detail pictures or else this video is gonna be 40 million hours long. This is Jack, Queen, and King. And I'm in love with this. Guys, I'm so stupid. It literally says on this side of the box what the characters are, like which book these characters are from. So it says character art inspired by Only a Monster, Daughter of the Moon Goddess, Six Crimson Cranes, and Jade Fire Gold. What is going on in my brain? All right, next order of business. We have to get rid of more grass in this box. So, it is this. I think this is some sort of tray, like a small tray. This kind of looks like it was inspired by Caravelle. The quote says, and there are really never endings, happy or otherwise. Okay, so this is from the Night Circus, not Caravelle. I really like that they specify what book it's from. But still, it's so pretty, look at it. I don't know how well I can show you with the glare, but it is lovely. Oh, there we go. It's so pretty, and you can see like the stars on it, and I'm pretty sure this clock is supposed to be kind of like a mix of time and like a Ferris wheel. I haven't read the book yet, so I could be completely wrong, but it kind of reminds me of that because like Ferris wheels and circuses, they remind me of like going to a fair and there's usually a Ferris wheel there. So next I have this. Wait, what is that? We gotta look at this first. Is this, what is this? Hold on. Addie canvas basket. Is this from Invisible? Oh, this might be from that same book again, like the Night Circus. Guys, I can't close this. Oh, there we go. The fabric that it's made of kind of reminds me of something you'd bring to the pool. So that way it's like waterproof, and I'm pretty sure it's meant to be like something you'd use in your bathroom. So this is what it looks like. It's, I think it's definitely from the same book because it's so pretty and it's like oriented on constellations and stars. Haven't completely straightened it out yet. There we go. But it still looks lovely. There you go, this is what it looks like. And then the front. All right, so next we have this. So it is a book and it is called An Arrow to the Moon by Emily X. R. Pan. I'm so excited. Like, it's so pretty just by looking at it. I have no idea what it's about, but I'm already like enthralled. Ah, spellbinding reinterpretation of Romeo and Juliet, filled with romance, magic, and Chinese mythology. I'm so excited to read this. And look at the beautiful edges. Like, tell me this isn't to die for. And also, that new book smell, amazing. It's the first page. It's signed. I love that. I don't know why I'm surprised every single time, but this is so beautiful. Oh my goodness. I'm so, aww. In the process of writing this, I almost thought I would never find my way out of the book, out of the woods, but I did. And so this book is for me. I love that. Oh my goodness, I'm so excited. I love this book, but I don't even, yeah, this isn't the book. I think this is just like a little bonus book. Oh, I almost dropped it. But it's so pretty. And you can see like the mountains and then the two main characters and the arrow. That definitely symbolizes something. And same thing with the stars and the mountains. And like, you can see that the arrow is also the peak of the mountain. So I'm pretty sure that definitely has a lot to do with the symbolism of this book. So I'm really excited to figure out what it is. Ooh, guys, we have more art. All right. Oh, I think these are the monthly, cards. All right, this is what they look like. They always come in really beautiful pairs and they're very, very well done. Whoa. And I think they're beautiful. I love that they're like collectible pieces of art, so I get to keep them. They're always really well done and I'm really excited. And now finally, for the moment of truth, is the actual book of the month itself. I'm guessing it's probably the Night Circus because everything is Night Circus themed, unless I'm wrong, but that's okay. Ooh, okay. Oh, it's the car. Whoa, whoa, there's a bookmark in here. Guys, all right. So we have this beautiful, oh, I dropped it. This beautiful bookmark. Oh, you can't see that very well. There you go. Oh, there you go. It's so pretty. It's the same girl from the spoiler card. I always love that they match, it's so good. And now we have our little Fairyloot brochure. I love reading these so much. I get to just learn so much about the author and like what inspired it and just like the theme. It's so pretty. Next month's theme, Cloak and Dagger. It says you can expect items inspired by From Blood and Ash, Red Rising, Daughter of the Moon Goddess, and our featured book of the month. Ooh. It's gonna include a ceramic mug and the next foil bookmarks in our mythology collection. Oh my gosh. I'm so excited. This is gonna be so good. I'm so excited. I love it already and I don't even have it. And now we have this beautiful work of art with a letter from the author on the back. I'm pretty sure this has gotta be the main character, but it doesn't look like a circus. So I think I got the book wrong. That's okay. But as you can see, this is beautiful and well done. And like, look at the intricate, like, everything. And finally, the book is Blood Scion by Deborah Flay. I might have said that wrong. I'm sorry if I did. But look at it. It is so beautiful. Judging by the art that is inspired by this, I already know we're gonna get, like, warrior kind of story. And I'm pretty sure there's gonna be a lot of cultural things that are involved in this. And I'm very excited to learn about it. So, let's remove the dust jacket. It's always my, oh my God. Look at this. That's so pretty. I love the style in the way it's painted. It definitely has to do with the culture and everything that just inspires the author. So I'm very, very excited to read this book. And I always love learning about new cultures and just, oh my gosh. Learning about new cultures and just everything around me. And like, look at this. It's so beautiful. Like, wow. Oh my gosh. Here you go. It is, I'm mind blown. This is so beautiful. I love how you can already see so much about the character even though you have no idea who she is, right? And it's so beautiful. Like, look at that detail. And it's only just the cover. So it's like, what else are we gonna learn? I'm so excited. I'm so excited. And the edges are beautifully sprayed blue. And I feel like it definitely has a lot of symbolism. Like, you can see so much of the character and I'm wondering if this is fire. Because I have seen in like different films and stuff like that, how lines drawn in this kind of design is usually used to represent fire. I could be wrong about that, but just judging by how the character is standing and how everything is kind of coming around her, it's like, it looks like flame. It looks like flame and smoke and how she's just standing there and she's like, I am here, I'm a powerful being, and no matter what challenge comes my way, I will be able to successfully overtake it or come through it. And so, before we forget, the dust jacket is so beautiful. We get a snippet about Deborah, and she's a Nigerian-Canadian young adult author, and she grew up in, I'm probably gonna say this wrong, Lagos, Nigeria, where she spent time devouring African literature, pestering her grandma for folk tales, and tricking her grandfather into watching Passions every night. When she's not writing about fierce black girls with badass magic, she can be found obsessing over all things reality TV. She currently lives in Toronto with her husband and their partner in crime, Yorkie, who's probably their dog, named Major. This is her very first novel, so I'm very excited to learn about it and just see what she incorporates from her life into this book, because every single author, no matter who you are, you always incorporate a part of yourself. Like, even I incorporate a part of myself into my writing, and so I'm really excited to learn about her culture and everything that she wants to embrace and to put into this book. Look at this. Like, look at this beautiful art. It is so well done, and it captures the entire essence of the book already, and I haven't even read it. Thank you so much for watching this Fairyloot unboxing video, and if you would like to see these products or these items closer up, just make sure you check out my Instagram, because I will be uploading more bookish photos about the book and about all of the trinkets that are in there. So thanks for watching, and I hope you like, comment, and subscribe, and you come back for more for next time. Bye, and I'll see you then.